The growing political battle over migrant workers in Australia got ugly today. The federal opposition questioning whether a senior advisor to the Prime Minister should have access to top secret information, given that he's on a temporary working visa in Australia. Our political editor Hugh Rimmington is here in Sydney tonight with more on this story. Hugh, can we expect more of this in a nasty election campaign?
Well, it hasn't really got nasty yet, Sandra, but they're just warming up. The Prime Minister will be here at Jones Bay Wharf a little later on this evening for a big top-end Labor Party fundraising dinner. Lovely views across the harbour. But the big brewing issue is about those people who come across the seas into our harbours, into this country, looking to pick up what the Labor movement says are Aussie jobs.
Out campaigning and making no pretense about it, Joe Hockey in Parramatta.
Thanks, mate.
Among those he met, Becky Bennett from Britain, working as a trainee manager on a 457 migrant workers visa.
Would you like to stay here? Or
yeah, not? Yeah, I'm hoping to.
She is someone that comes to Australia wanting a better life. Isn't that great?
The Prime Minister's promise to fight for Aussie jobs first threatens a crackdown on migrant visas.
I don't want to hear stories of Australians missing out on a job because a 457 visa has been misused.
How many people in her office has she got on 457 visas? If she's so concerned about it, why did they get security clearances?
His particular target, Scotsman John McTernan, the Prime Minister's key communications strategist.
Western Sydney has some of the worst unemployment in the country, in some places twice the national average. Both sides know if they want to win votes here, they have to address concerns over job security.
And the attack on migrant visas resonates here.
Yeah, I think Australians should come first.
Any country has to give the priority to the people from the country.
The opposition, meanwhile, is in a tangle over tax.
The assurance that I give is that families will be better off.
Not so fast, says Joe Hockey.
I can't look people in the eye here and make promises that we cannot deliver. I will not do it. I won't.
What we've got going on today is a complete disagreement between Tony Abbott and Joe Hockey.
And a quick back pedal. Tony Abbott saying later we'll know the coalition tax plan in good time.
Now, I can tell you that a source not a million miles from the Prime Minister's office has said that if the opposition is so exercised over the fact that John McTernan, a Brit, has access to security information in his role in the Prime Minister's office, how come the coalition is so keen to keep a Briton, that is to say the Queen, as our head of state, Sandra?
Hugh Rimmington, thank you.